Hi, I'm Antonio Buzaid. We're here at our breast cancer meeting with Carlos Barrios, one of the organizers, as well with Professor Hope Hugo, who is a professor at the University of California, San Francisco. And today we're going to talk about biosimilars. Now, we know that very well-designed phase 3 trials have approved many biosimilars in the whole world, and that have shown efficacy and safety, which are similar to the original drug. Now, Dr. Hugo was the first author of the Heritage study, which compared a trastuzumab biosimilar with trastuzumab original agent in combination with a taxane and showed similar response rate, time to progression, and overall survival. Now, in general, Hope, how do you see biosimilars in the world? How important are they, high-quality biosimilars I'm referring to?
I think that biosimilars are, I think, a key to the future of treatment, not just in oncology, but also in other fields where biosimilars are being used, autoimmune diseases, diabetes, et cetera. I think there are a number of different factors that are really important. One is, of course, access to life-saving drugs in the world as a whole, where access to these agents is surprisingly poor, at least if you're coming from the U.S. perspective. Also use have been quite tightly regulated in order to provide enough funding to treat other diseases in countries that are low on funding overall for healthcare. So that's one area. But in addition, in the developed world where there is health insurance paying for it or the government is paying for it, we need to reduce the costs overall because we have new drugs coming up behind and they're here already, immunotherapy, et cetera, that are using a large part of our healthcare dollars. So I think that competition has always been a good thing in terms of providing medications for our patients and stimulating development of new medications. And this is no different. It's expected to result in an enormous savings for healthcare in the United States as well as around the world.
Barrios, how do you see biosimilars in general in oncology or in medicine, as Hope pointed out?
I think that cancer is a fantastic problem all over the world, not only in the developed countries. And recent information is pointing out to the fact that it's becoming more and more important in developing nations, where the access issue is one of the most important and perverse discrepancies that we have. So anything we can do in order to change that situation and make people actually be treated in the best possible way and have access to best treatments is essential. We have information that of the available medications that have been released into the market over the last 5 years, only 10% are consumed outside Japan, US, and Western Europe. So that essentially tells you what the results of treating cancer in these regions actually are. And the discrepancies on the results are obviously related in part to that. So I see biosimilars with a very important objective in terms of their application to clinical practice all over the world. And I'm waiting to see that they actually change the access situation all over the place. So I think it's a very important critical issue, and I put a lot of weight on companies developing quality biosimilars to improve the healthcare outcomes of patients all over the world.
Yeah, increased access is definitely one of the most important factors that my high quality biosimilars can provide. There's no question about that. What make a biosimilar of high quality?
The way biosimilars are compared to the original compound is heavily weighted on analytics. So looking at the analytic components of understanding the biosimilar versus the originator compound. But from the clinical standpoint, what we really focus on is after those things have been shown to be similar enough, We focus on the clinical output. And what the regulatory agencies have put forth is that you need to show that you have used a highly sensitive short-term clinical endpoint in order to show biosimilarity. So HER2-positive disease in breast cancer is actually a really good indicator, and the trials have looked at both pathologic complete response in the neoadjuvant setting and response in the metastatic setting as short-term clinical endpoints. And all of these trials that are well-powered with well-studied biosimilars have shown equivalency. What's very cool, I think, and it wasn't really intended in the guidelines from the beginning, is that these trials have been followed out, in particular the metastatic heritage trial that was recently reported the survival data, to show that this short-term clinical endpoint correlates to similarity in progression-free survival and overall survival. And we're going to see that from the neoadjuvant studies as well. This really, I think, enhances our confidence in using these drugs in substitution for the originator compound.
Well, very good. So you heard Dr. Barrios and Dr. Hugo as to the importance of biosimilars, not just in oncology, but in the whole field of medicine. Thank you.